what motivated me, I think children are a very special population, and unfortunately, as there are many children in need, and children who don't receive appropriate healthcare, and actually many of them in the United States. What we notice is number of children's chronic conditions in the U.S. are going up, despite there not being a real reason for why we are seeing more children having those chronic health conditions. So we noticed that there was a big change in the structure of Medicaid. They changed the payment system. So how do they pay doctors? So instead of paying them per every service that they provide, they actually decided to pay doctors in what is called Medicaid managed care. They paid them a lump sum amount, and then from that amount, the doctors were reimbursed for caring for children. So we noticed that this change actually created such incentives for providers that they diagnosed more of certain chronic conditions. And including one of the conditions that particularly interests me is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Well, maybe it is a good thing that we diagnose more children now and prescribe them more medication under this new system. Well, it turns out that it's not the case. So what I find is pretty dramatic, and that although children with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder who are diagnosed and treated, they do behave better. They have fewer injuries, fewer risky sexual behavior outcomes, fewer instances of substance use and abuse, but actually in the school, which is one of the reasons why many ADHD children are diagnosed, they're not doing any better. So I think, yeah, this was an important advance to what medical literature is suggesting. And I think where economists can actually contribute is because we have access to a lot of administrative data and long-term outcomes where clinical trials really just physically cannot address these questions.